Do you remember how much panic and curiosity was stirred up by those mysterious crop circles appearing everywhere throughout the world? Well, this time, little green men are not the cause. The reasons given are of a more earthly origin. Termites, micro-tornadoes, the foundations of ancient underground structures, and crafty men using a stick and a rope. We barely had time to come down from this hype when thousands of perfectly circular holes were found dotting the seabed. And this time, we can't suspect any of the previous possible culprits. So, where did these mysterious anomalies come from, and do they pose a threat to humanity? This unusual phenomenon occurred at the bottom of the Pacific Ocean, off the coast of Big Sur, California. Researchers at the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute discovered a vast field at the bottom of the water, which spans about 1,300 square kilometers, or 502 square miles, and has approximately 5,200 pits, or pockmarks, which on average measure about 175 meters, or 574 feet in diameter, and 5 meters, or 16 feet deep. Dotting the sea bottom around the larger pits were found smaller holes, or micro-depressions, measuring only 11 meters or 36 feet wide and about 1 meter or 3 feet deep. In total, the number of these holes amounts to about 15,000. They all have a perfectly round shape, and no one has any idea how these holes came to be. What we know exactly is the age of these holes. They were formed about 400,000 years ago. That is, they'd existed for 100,000 years before even the first Homo sapiens emerged. At least, that's the age according to carbon dating. According to research, the largest holes haven't changed for more than 50,000 years. That is, back when not a single human being inhabited the California shore, or for that matter, the whole of the Americas. People appeared around those parts only 13,000 years ago, and they've been living there to this day. Due to this, the pits in the seabed are filled with debris of anthropogenic origin. A third of the holes are full of plastic trash bags and 18.9 liter or 5 gallon buckets. And a fifth of the holes contain material of a natural origin, such as cobblestones and whale skulls. Perhaps these weird, perfect holes come about as a result of the release of methane. This gas could have bubbled up to create these depressions. However, analysis of the water chemistry showed no traces indicating the presence of methane. So there must be something else involved. Some researchers try to explain the emergence of the holes by citing underwater currents. Others believe that this phenomenon is somehow associated with animal activity. They hypothesize that these pits were much smaller originally, with the width and depth of the pits enhanced by underwater creatures hundreds of thousands of years ago. However, both of these hypotheses are still very much in doubt. However, there are many other holes in the oceans that can be attributed to animals. In 2018, a team of scientists from the National Oceanography Center, Southampton, using an underwater robot at a depth of 4 kilometers or 2.4 miles, discovered approximately 3,500 gigantic depressions across an area similar in size to that of central London. These depressions are found in the bottom of the Pacific Ocean, in an area between Hawaii and Mexico. The pits are 2.5 meters or 8.2 feet wide and approximately 13 centimeters or 5.1 inches deep. This discovery has failed to be explained in terms of geology, so the scientists agreed that they had to be footprints. But no known existing marine or terrestrial animals are capable of leaving such enormous footprints, especially at such depths where few living organisms can exist, let alone feel free to tread on the sea floor. Even a footprint made by the largest dinosaur ever known, which was discovered in Australia, is far smaller than this find, with a length of 1.75 meters or about 5.7 feet. The ocean depths never cease to amaze. After all, they're far less studied than even the most distant galaxies. Even black holes in space were discovered earlier than those in the ocean. And yes, you heard that right. Black holes in the ocean do exist. At least, you can call them such, mathematically speaking. Scientists from the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Zurich and the University of Miami used computer models and satellite data to reveal unusual funnels in the ocean, in almost all respects analogous to black holes in space. Nothing can escape a black hole, even light. And nothing very small in size is capable of escaping an ocean black hole, including living organisms and even particles of water or sand. Most of these holes are found in the southern part of the Atlantic Ocean. These holes do seem quite convenient for the planet, with their ability to suck all garbage into themselves, thus trafficking clean and warm waters from the southern to the northern part of the ocean. But being caught by such a hole means certain death. Unless, of course, you're lucky enough to be of a larger size. In turn, some holes in the ocean, although they're not mathematical copies of black holes, act as a true marine cemetery. I bet many of you saw a photo of the Great Blue Hole, which was discovered by the famous French ocean explorer Jacques Cousteau. Back in 1972, he determined that the amount of oxygen in this hole was too little for complex life to exist. And in 2019, his grandson, Fabien Cousteau, and billionaire Richard Branson descended to the bottom of the Great Blue Hole. It's 124 meters, or 406.8 feet deep, and 300 meters, or 984.2 feet wide. It's turned out that there's a real graveyard of mollusks in the seabed there. When mollusks get in there accidentally, they suffocate due to insufficient oxygen, and after that they die, their carcasses dotting the bottom of the Great Blue Hole. The ocean didn't escape changes in its relief resulting from human activity either, with a scar left by people more than 70 years ago. We're talking about the Bikini Atoll in the Marshall Islands. 23 nuclear bombs were detonated there between 1946 to 1958. Researchers mapped traces of the explosions at the bottom of the ocean. The signs of damage were twice the size of New York City's Central Park. The largest crater has an unusual oblong shape, with a diameter of 2,000 meters, or 6,560 feet, and a depth of 76 meters, or 250 feet. Based on these indicators, the researchers determined that the crater emerged from several blasts, the 15-megaton bomb Castle Bravo and the 11-megaton bomb called Castle Romeo, with the radioactive chemical elements remaining at the bottom of the crater after these blasts until now. But none of these holes poses such a threat to humanity and the entire planet as the fact that the bottom itself dissolves. It just disappears. For obtaining proof, you don't need to go to the bottom of the sea. Laboratory measurements will be sufficient. By mimicking the exact chemical composition of the seabed soil by adding seawater, you'll find the soil begin to dissolve. The seafloor is chalk white, since the majority of it is covered with calcite. On the surface, this is found as limestone and chalk. But at the bottom of the ocean, calcite is formed from the skeletons and shells of marine animals, as well as calcareous algae. This layer is a true airbag for the ocean. Calcite saves the oceans from carbon dioxide, which oxidizes its waters and destroys coral reefs. Too much CO2 creates a kind of vicious circle. The more acidic the ocean water is, the more intensively the protective layer at the bottom dissolves, leading to even greater acidification of the ocean. What will happen if ocean acidification continues unabated? I've told you more than once in my videos, but the short answer is that it will mean the end of mankind. it's hard to say whether the holes at the bottom of the coast in California are somehow associated with carbon dioxide. However, the destructive processes in the ocean demonstrate once again how fine-tuned our planet is. Only a little extra of any substance, CO2 in this case, will result in devastating consequences at all levels. This suggests that anthropogenic destructive activity has hit the bottom, both literally and figuratively. True, there is good in it. The oceanic analogs of black holes that I mentioned before, they give hope that global warming can be stopped at the level of the sea. But can it succeed? Please leave your thoughts in the comments.